Okay, folks, hopefully everybody stopped and looked up all those scriptures I left y'all with. The Bible says Jesus said these words, "Do not your own scriptures say, I said, you are God's." There's no arguing that. You can't argue it. He also was quoting Psalm 82, "I have said, you are God's. You are all children of the Most High, but you will die like men. You will fall like one of the princes." So a bunch of princes fell. They got trapped in host bodies, so they die like men. That's exactly correct. Now, I'm going to show you. Now, let's just talk for a sec. Let me show you something. So if we've been carried away captive into their world. Okay, well then it should be easy if one of us has awakened, it should be easy for one of us to show everybody else their world. Because I was awakened in a world I don't even belong to. That's what the Bible says. Arise, O sleeper, wake up from the dead, and Christ will give you light. The Bible says you are in the world, you're not of the world. Jesus said, my kingdom is not of this world. Jesus said, if the world hates you, know that it hated me before you. I have chosen you out of the world. So see, all the scriptures are perfect. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you a slew of little video clips. How the ones that run this earth, the angel of the bottomless pits, that's running the above ground trap host body system, because they set the bait. That was the bait. Create the host body system, male and female. Let the watchers, God's angels, just look at it, start coveting it, wanting it. That's what happened. Now watch, I'm going to just use the gift the Lord gave me just to prove it to you. Okay, so let's do it. Let's enjoy ourselves. Let's have fun. This is the greatest gift in the I've ever seen. I mean, I have nothing to do with it. Nothing. I am simply a facilitator of the gift that the Lord God's giving. That's all. I don't want any credit for this. I don't deserve any. I'm just a pathetic sinner that got saved. And that's it. And I'm just glad to get to do something for the king. Okay, here we go. Okay, now, maybe some of y'all have heard of the movie Lucy. Y'all know that Lucy is a short for Lucifer, right? You see that there's a clothing line called Lucky 13. It's a Lucifer-based clothing line. Here we go. Ready? Let's watch a clip from Lucy. And you know what? Before I show you the clip, I'm gonna qualify it. So this altar right here is everything to these creatures, because they used the host body system as a means to capture angels. So this whole thing, y'all know, is a dead sheep. It's a penis, it's a vagina, and it's a bunch of angels melting into semen. Let's see if we can look at a clip from a movie, Lucy, and see if they have that in there. Let's watch. I'm going to pause it right here. I want you to look right here. You see the hole that was all this light? And then look at the one that's breaking away. See it? It's breaking away. Watch. Pause it right there for just a moment. Do you know what you're looking at? You're looking at a movie called Lucy. It's showing this cosmic event in the heavens. One part is breaking off from a main part. And all of a sudden you have sperm coming down from heaven. And what I did was I took those part of the movie and I superimposed it on the same altar that is the identical thing in the Vatican. The dead sheep, angels turning into semen. The spirit of Elohim moved over the semen. Genesis 1, verse 2. Watch. Here it is. There it is. I'm going to pause it now. Even in the movie, it shows them coming and then they turn as the part to turn. The spirit of Elohim. I'm going to show you real quickly in the Bible. Right here. The spirit right here of Elohim. Right here. God's. Of the Supreme God. You see the part that broke off of the Supreme God moved upon the face. Look, as the part that turns of the waters, semen. There it is. You're seeing it in a movie. I mean, I don't know how I could make this any more plain for you. This is exactly what's in the movie. Watch. So there you go. And I just took it and I put it right there and we superimposed the movie, the dimension they're going into, right into the altar. Watch. Okay, now, I honestly don't know how to make this any more plain. I just gave you the exact definition from Genesis 1, verse 2. The spirit of Elohim moved over the face as the part that turns of the semen. I just showed you the exact thing in a movie called Lucy, like, you know, Lucy, Lucifer. That altar is a big altar to Lucifer and his creation, Genesis 1. That's what the whole altar is. Okay. Let's keep doing it. Okay, so there's that. Now, here's the Adidas original commercial. Adidas original. Tell me what is odd about this picture. What is it? I mean, what's odd about it? First, there's five. One, two, three, four, five. I told you the whole system is Roman numeral five, Roman numeral five. And they like a U and a U, or they use a V and a V, and it makes a W because there's a good U and there is a bad U. There's a double U. Good and evil, you. You're the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. You are that tree. We're the above ground part that's being run from the pit because they set the host body trap for God's angels. Are you a watcher? Are you a dancer? Watch. So here's Adidas' original commercial. Well, what's the original formation in the Bible? Right here, Genesis 1. In Genesis 1, watch. Genesis 1, verse 26. And Elohim, just when you see 4:30, say Elohim. Don't say God. Say Elohim said, let us make man in our vain show. Phantom, a phantom. That is, the word is image. It's Selem. Say it out loud. Selem. It means a phantom. That is figuratively an illusion. Resemblance, hence a representative figure, especially an idol. Vain show. So Elohim said, let us make man a hypocrite, a human being hypocrite, in our vain show. Representative figure, especially an idol. So Elohim created man, a hypocrite, human being, in his own vain show. In the vain show of Elohim created he him. Male and female. Look at this. Created he him. That's Lucifer creating himself, male and female. Now, I showed you the little, my little prop. Let me show it to you again. So Lucifer's the light bringer. So here comes all the light from heaven that he's going to bring into the system. Picture that window in the Vatican. And then everybody, many in one, and we all get birthed into the system. And all those little lights get trapped in host bodies with an angel and a demon from the other side, locked up together within the host body. This is perfection in understanding. This is not, I could not do this. There's no one that could do this. This is a gift from God. So here we go. So in the image of God, in the image of Elohim, created he him. Now look at this. This is so important. In the image of Elohim, see gods, it's plural, many in one. In the image of Elohim, created he him. So he's many in one. Male and female, created he them. So see, there's a male and female system that what came down became duplicitous. Male and female, go forth and multiply. Well, that race that got produced right there, be fruitful and multiply, they started producing all the fruit from that race. Well, what race is that? Well, that's the original. Let me look, let me show you a commercial that shoves it in your face. Adidas original. What do you notice? They're all upside down. Let me quote Isaiah 29, 15, and 16. Woe unto them who go to great depths to hide their plans from the Lord. Their works are in the darkness, and they say, who seeth us? Who knoweth us? Surely your turning of things upside down shall be esteemed as a potter's clay, which is what the Lord God created. The potter's clay is what the Lord God formed in Genesis 2. Adam, and then he took Eve from his side. So now watch. Do these guys look good? Okay, do you know what you just saw right there? You just saw the representative of everlasting forward and backwards chains of darkness. I'm going to show you every time now. I'm going to go to the Bible with everything I show you. Jude 1. Okay, and angels which kept not their first estate, which was heaven, but left their own habitation, he hath reserved in, look, everlasting chains. Look at the word everlasting. Forward and backwards. Chains, ligaments, a band, that is a ligament of the body or shackle of a prisoner. That's why one's forward. That's why one's backwards. That's why they're black and white and they're identical twins. Because this is the duplicitous system that we're caught in. Now this dark figure wakes up. This represents the consciousness of what you just saw awakening. Watch. You see that? The duplicitous forward and backwards chains of darkness. Here's their boss. There you go. And look at this. No, that's not demonic.
I did what I had to do. And saw it through.
I did what I had to do and saw it through without exception. Look at this picture right here. Here's the boss. This is the Prince of Darkness ruling over the duplicitous twin system. And look what's on the floor. Their mirror reflection. Do you understand that this every segment that was filmed was storyboarded? When I do big videos or DVDs, we storyboard what's going to go in it. And you have to decide, what message are we trying to convey? Look at the storyboard. Oh my gosh, you got to be joking. Look at that. Here's the boss of the twin forward and backward system, back to back. And look, they have their mirror reflection. Okay, and by the way, that's two females because just like Dos Equis beer, the female chromosome is X and X.
Without exemption.
And I saw it through without exception. I'm sorry, I saw it through without exception. Watch.
And saw it through.
Well, saw what through? Oh, the whole race turned upside down. Do you see?
Without exemption.
I planned each charted course, each careful step.
Along the byway.
And more.
Much more than this.
I did it.
Okay, and I've shown you all that, but at the risk of being redundant, I'm going to show you again. And let's just get a Google Images. Birth of Venus. There you go, Birth of Venus. And I will prove it. Everything I tell you, I will prove. You see it? There it is. Bocelli. Sandro Botticelli, The Birth of Venus. There it is. Okay, so this is the birth of Lucifer. Lucifer is Venus. I just proved it. I showed it to you. Is that what that is? It's a yes or no answer. Is that the birth of Venus? It is exactly. You see how they did the double face right here? Duplicitous.
I did it my way.
Now watch this turn into like artificial intelligence and all this goes to black. Watch. There you go. The new system AI has come in now. And now it's morphed into something new. In the end, the last kingdom of the world would be the iron mixed with the miry clay. And the iron's going to take over. That's what you're looking at.
Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I bit off more than I could chew. But through it all, when there was doubt, I ate it up and spit it out. I faced it
Okay, original is never finished. This is nothing less than the Prince of Darkness, the Angel of the Bottomless Pit, Satan, Apollyon, Abaddon, just using the host body system to do a commercial. That's all you're looking at. He's saying, I did it my way. That's what this commercial is. Are they trying to sell you clothes? Random. Let's keep going. Okay, now, the whole you're going to get a hot chick thing was a trick. Okay. Oh, no, I can offer you females, and you can have sex and be creators, co-creators, and all that great stuff. No. No, it was a trap. It was bait. Because what you thought looked really good actually ended up being an illusion, a vain show, a phantom. It's not even real. Listen to the song they play right now. Listen to the song for this commercial. Listen to the lyrics. And I'm going to pause it a few times to show you what some things are. Ready? Watch when the eye opens up, it turns to an insect eye. Right there. That is omatidia right there. You see those? Now I'm gonna prove it. I'm all about proving what I say. Okay? So I'm gonna prove it out. I'm gonna show you Google Images. Omatidia. I believe that's how you spell it. Omatidia eyes. There's two M's. Okay, there we go. So omatidia eyes. There you go. There's omatidia. That's insect eyes. You see right there? Let's see. And all they did was make it just go from one. Now ready? Let's go. Oh, is that what that is? I see. I recognize it. The Lord gave me a skill set before I got saved that I would be able to show you these things. Look, that's what it is. So now the eye that opened, that looked like something really great. He thinks he's going to get some hot babe. He's really breeding with the other side that set the trap by proxy. So he's really having sex with an insect race, but just doesn't know it. Watch. So there the eyes are. Oh, look. I was at this store the other day, and when I saw these, I was like, you got to be joking. So hang on, let me show you. What do you think about those? Aren't those great? Look. Oh, so I gotta. Yeah, look. Look, you can turn yourself into a bug. How cool. And you know what? They actually have a compound lens in it right there. Look. I'm not joking. See the compound lens? So you can see the way a bug sees. Isn't that great? I mean, everybody needs a pair of bug glasses. You're in their world. You were carried away captive because of a decision you live. By the way, Jesus said, my words are spirit. And he says, Jesus said in the Bible, I'm sorry, that you should, the word of God is his food, that he is the bread of life, and that his words are spirit. My words are spirit. So, what do we consume for spiritual food? The word. That's what I consume. I just devour the word of God. That's my spiritual food. Well, what if you were listening to Lucifer's words? Would you be devouring his spirit? Would you be, if you're listening to him? Just think about it. So, how were you led astray? Did you listen? Okay, now watch. Here we go. Watch.
No one told me about her, the way she lied.
No one told me about her, the way she lied. Lucifer is a, well, I'm going to just stick with Satan. Lucifer was his name before he got cast down. Now he's the accuser of the brethren, Satan. Okay, well, Satan is a liar. And when he lies, it's consistent with his character. He's the father of lies and a murderer. Well, look at her leg bent. It's a triangle on purpose. Now watch this. You see this right here? Like the little capstone? Now she's going to lean back, and I'm just going to tell you what she's going to do, and you're going to just watch it. She's going to take her perfume, dip it, and then she's going to make 666 with her hand and turn it upside down. Put it on her as the bait. She's going to lean behind some glass because she's really a phantom image. She's a shadow. He thinks it's a hot babe, but it's a trick. It's a lie. Watch.
Well, no one told me about how many people cried, but it's too late to say you're sorry. How would I know? Why should I care? Please don't bother trying to find her. She's not there. Well, let me tell you about the way she looked, the way.
she had tanned the color of my hair. Her voice was soft and cool, her eyes were clear and bright, but she's not bad.
Oh, wow, so... her eyes were clear and bright, but she's not there. Knockout punch. You're trapped in the vesica piscis, buddy. Watch. Here we go. So what looked really good, the bait, turns to light, turns to darkness. Just like us, we went from light to darkness. Ready? Cast down. Cast down. Knocked out. Cast down. Knocked out in the middle of the two different intersecting sets. There you are, trapped. You see what I mean? It's all the same. It's always the same. I can literally do this all day and all night long now. Just watch. We're gonna tear this kingdom to shreds right now. Okay, so there it is. So now let's do another one. The Poison Club. Well, that one was a girl that looked like a really great deal. And now let's see what's up. It says, I am poison. Well, I am is the name of God. I am that I am. Now watch this. I am poison. Well, this is kind of a slap at the watchers. Angels that were watching the host body system, and they thought they wanted to play the game. And the girl in this commercial says, are you a watcher? You know, like one of the watchers from heaven. What happened to God's angels? They started coveting, desire, lusting after the daughters of men. They're like, oh, Lucifer, yeah, I can give you all that. Watch.
Are you a watcher or a dancer?
Are you going to come dance with me? Well, it's going to cost you everything. So now watch. Are you a watcher or a dancer? Now I'm just going to fast forward to the end because we don't need to watch them do their sexy, sexy dance. Here we go.
We're not girls. We're poison.
We're not girls. We're poison. You know, V stands 5 and 5, male and female. Put them together and you got a double U, X chromosome ruling the system. It's all the same. It's no different than the commercial I just showed you of Coco Mademoiselle. But she's not there. Knockout punch. We're not girls. We're poison. Neither shall you touch it, lest ye die. Okay, here we go. Here you go. So, let's do another one. Okay, There's your guy got knocked out, trapped in the vesica. We're not girls, we're poison. She's got the V on the side of her face, number 5. Let's look at this one. Now, let me ask you a question before we watch this one. Have you ever bought a car? I have. I bought lots of cars in my life. Have you ever taken advice from an 11-year-old girl to buy a car? No, never did. Would I care if an 11-year-old girl told me, what car to buy? No, I wouldn't care at all. I'd be like, what? 11-year-old girls don't drive. 11-year-old girls, they don't know anything about a vehicle. They don't know anything about engines or nothing. But that makes them fully equipped and, you know, the right person to sell you a car, of course. So let's see what she's telling us. What's that? That's an overwhelming wave that's like coming to destroy all of us.
The world.
What's that? That's a tornado about to take out a church building that's all by itself out in a field, and it's about to be utterly destroyed. She says the world, it's full of giants. Oh, Genesis 6, there were giants on the earth in those days and after that. Let's just keep going.
It's full of giants.
Oh, the world is full of giants. Now darkness covers the earth. Isaiah 60, I believe, darkness shall cover 61, darkness shall cover the earth and gross darkness the people of the earth. Watch, here goes the shadow over the earth. Ready? Watch the shadow.
Giants.
Now there's the consciousness awakening within the little girl's host body. The shadow covers, consciousness awakes.
I've always been here.
God's eye, dream catcher. Now her consciousness is awake and she's going to look at her own mirror image.
Lumbering in the schoolyards, limping.
Look at this. Right side up, upside down, because that's what the fuel for their fire is. The right side up, upside down paradigm. That's why Jesus was crucified right side up and Peter upside down. The same as those two vowels right there. That's the system that burns you to bits. And they know it. They're making fun of you. Watch.
Through the alleys, we had to learn how to deal with them. How to overcome them. We were small, but fast. Remember? We were like a wind appearing out of...
This is a reference to Matthew 13, the parable of the mustard seed. It's the smallest of all seeds, you know, like a sperm, but becomes the largest of all herbs, and birds of the air come and nest. Oh, angels nesting in host bodies.
Nowhere. We knew that being clever was more important than being the biggest kid in the neighborhood. As long as we keep our heads down, as long as we work hard, trust what we feel in our guts.
Isn't that fascinating? They have a big fishing net. What is this? Have y'all seen a car yet? This is a Maserati commercial.
Our hearts. Then we're ready. We wait until they get us. Then we're ready. Then we're ready. Then we're ready. We wait until they get sleepy. Wait until they get so big they can barely move. Then we walk out of the shadows. Quietly walk out of the dark. And strike.
Oh, did you know that's the same as lurking class clothing? You know, the veil that they're coming out from behind the veil? We'll see it again. What the hell does this have to do with a car? Nothing. Now, they're going to gratuitously show you an engine start up and a car go through a few gears. But let's see what the main focal point of this car is when they come out to strike. Who's going to strike? Let's see.
Of the dark. And strike.
Oh, what's the first thing you see? Run! And what do you see? A trident, which is a representation of the angel of the bottomless pit. There you go. Now, they run through a few gears, and that's all you see. They don't tell you anything about the car. Now, look what it says. We have prepared, because they've been preparing since the beginning of the world to strike, to come out of the pit and to strike. They think they're going to make war against the Lord God. That's what this commercial is. It's not a car commercial. Watch. We have prepared. Now we strike. Let me ask you a question again. What kind of animals strike when they attack? Let's see, one I know is a scorpion strikes. Scorpions strike, and a serpent strikes. I've been bit by a snake. It bit me 3 times so fast. I was like, bing, whoa, bing, whoa, boot. I was like, oh my God, I just got bit 3 times. It happened so fast. It was insane. It happens fast. That's the point. When it goes down, no one's going to be ready for it. Unless you've been preparing your heart for this, which I've been trying to do for y'all. That's what my mission is. Okay, so we have prepared. Now we're strike. Now, I want to hear her say this little part. Then we're ready. We come out of the shadows. Let's see. Then we're ready.
Big, they can barely move. Then we walk out of the shadows. Quietly walk out of the dark
and strike.
I mean, that is uber evil. We have, she said, then we're ready. I want to get to the part to where she says we're ready right here. Watch.
Then we're ready. We're ready. Then we're ready. Then we're ready.
Okay, I wanted to do that because I'm going to play you another thing now. So she said, then we're ready. We're ready. There. So that's the monster from the pit saying, we're ready. Let's look at another NFL commercial. Ready? And I'm going to go to a folder after this and show you what some of these numbers mean. And I'm going to take the numbers right out of the Strong's Concordance just to prove it again, because I've got their playbook now. There's nothing they can do about it. Ready? Little girl just said, then we're ready. We come out of the darkness, walk out of the shadows, walk out of the shadows, come out of the darkness, and strike. Let's hear what these guys have to say. We're ready, we're ready, we're ready for y'all. Wow. See, it's another race of beings. This is their above ground race. Okay, so you get the point. We're ready. They're saying they're ready. Now let me show you some stuff that I'm going to just knock off. You see these guys coming down the ramp. What are they going to do? They're walking down the ramp because they're walking out onto the field of battle. And they're going to go. It's a contest. They're walking through the ramp to go onto the field of battle, the field of, you know, the athletic contest. And there's certain numbers on their jerseys. Well, this is the spiritual supernatural gift the Lord gave me to share with you. Let me show you what it means in just a minute. Let me show you another scene that we're going to look at. See these little kids? 4, 6, 3. They're all on the same team. They're kindred. They're all on the same team together. And what's on their chest? Angel wings. Okay, so let's take a little look here again. Now watch this. Here come the guys down the ramp. Okay, now you see the saints right here? The saints. Okay, watch what's next. Oh, a scorpion sting. Nice. So you think that coach does, he's scorpion stinger. Just saw the saints. Now it's time for the chief. The chief, you know, like the angel of the bombless pit, the chief scorpion stinger. Wow. This is getting crazy, isn't it? It's getting good. Let's see. Oh, wow. Look, when he did the scorpion stinger, what's on these guys' jerseys? Lightning bolts. No way. I beheld Satan fall as lightning from heaven. See? This is all orchestrated, perfectly orchestrated, really well. So we're ready, just like the little girl. Now let's go look at a couple pictures and let me show you some numbers. Okay, again, I told you. Here we go. There's number 54. They put him right in the center of the thing. So let's look up 54. And it's, you know, they love the angel bottomless pit loves bragging about himself. Like he's the big cheese, and you know, here he is actually. Okay, the great one is Father. Oh, wow, that's what that means. Number 54. 54. Okay, now let's look at the other numbers on the other jerseys. Okay, here's 4, 6, 3. Remember the little kids? All with angel wings, because these are different angels we're talking about. So let's look up 4, 6, 3 in the Strong's. 4, 6, 3 is God is kinsmen. Oh, because they're all kinsmen, they're all the same angel group. Do you get it? That's why they use 4, 6, 3. Let's keep going. Okay, now, what about the guys walking down the ramp? Okay, you had 75. I'm going to enlarge it. We had number 75, 15, and 62. Now, this is the way the Lord teaches me. 75, these guys are together. This guy's off to the side a little bit. These numbers go together. 15, 62, and 75 will stand by itself. 75 means to contend with an adversary. 1562 means to strip naked. Wow, that's how they contended with us as their adversary. Come on, we'll give you host bodies. They clothed us. Light beings got clothed with nakedness. And I'm going to share that to you right there in the Bible. It's exactly what the Bible says. It's not that we took something off. We were clothed with nakedness. Watch. And when they used to capture prisoners back in the old days, and they would take them to their city as prisoners, they would walk them through the streets naked to humiliate them and say, y'all are our slaves. Look, 75, agonizomai, I know the word, it's Greek. I am struggling, striving, as an athletic contest or warfare. What? Tell me you are joking. Tell me you're joking. Right there. Athletic contest or warfare. 75, now 15, 62. 75 means, again, I am struggling, striving as an athletic contest or warfare. I contend as with an adversary. I mean, you can't make this stuff up, folks. So let's look up the next numbers. 1562. So we'll look up 1562. I've already done it and made it one of the show note numbers because now I know what they're doing, exactly what they're doing. 1562. Put off, take off, strip off of the garment or both. To strip off and make naked. Wow. Let's go to the Bible. Okay, Genesis. Genesis chapter 3, the fall, the representation of the fall. And unto Adam and to his wife did the Lord God, the self-existent eternal Jehovah Elohim. Not Elohim, the self-existent eternal Jehovah Elohim. He did make, look, to do or to make in the broadest and widest sense, to accomplish, to make coats, look. It means to cover like a shirt, a coat, a garment, or a robe. He made coats of, look, nakedness, skin as naked. You walk it back to the root of the word, be made naked. So see, we were clothed. You take a light beam, you take a light beam, you take one of these light beams, and you put them in a naked suit host body. That's what it means. It's different than the way other people perceive it, but this is the gift the Lord's allowed me to understand. So we, Adam and Eve, were clothed. The Lord God did make coats of nakedness, host bodies, and he clothed them. He's in control of all of it. Now, let's go. Let's keep going. Let's see, album number, let's see, NFL, 1562, to put off, strip, to be made naked. Now, I'm going to go to the Bible again, because everything you're seeing, all these commercials, everything I've shown you is straight out of the Bible, and I'm going to prove every time the same thing. Isaiah 29, now these are the words of the letter that the Jeremiah the prophet sent from Jerusalem unto the residue of the elders, which were Kleck, carried away captives. Let me show you what carried away captives means. Now, remember, the Bible says we are exiles. We were exiled. Live out your life as exiles. That's what the Bible says. It means exile. It means carried away. Look at the root of the word. It means to denude. To, look, captives as being stripped. My goodness, there it is. Captives as being stripped, figuratively to reveal. disclose. So if you were listening to Lucifer as an angel, and he was telling you, no, I can give this to you, and you were trying to be all covert about it, well, you were made naked, because if you were in any way, shape, or form aligned with that, you were revealed and you were exposed and made naked. Therefore, you get a host body suit and you get to go as an exile and live out your life in a host body. And the angel of the bottomless pit has dominion over you now. And unless you get converted, you don't go back home. This is perfection in data again. Absolute perfection. Here we go. Now, let's go back to the album. Let's see. So here is, I took the coach. There he is. Look, see the coach? The chief. There's the chief. Look at him. I know what he's doing. You think he's doing a Cam Newton dab? No, kind of. But here's what he's doing. Here's a scorpion. I'll put it right there. That's what he's doing. He's doing a scorpion stinging. The chief is stinging. That's why they showed you the Saints. So look, I'll take the scorpion. I just drew in some white lines on him. Bam! He's doing a scorpion stinger. Here's a t-shirt that says STFU, and it's a finger with fangs over some lips. Like, shut the F up, because they know the angel of the bottomless pit that's running the show here. He knows it's a cannibalistic system. There's a good you and a bad you, and you're self-cannibalizing because you got caught in the host body system, which is called the Kelepot in Jewish Kabbalistic cosmology. The Kelepot, you know, the Kabbalistic Jews, you know, the ones that are into mysticism, they know what the hell's going on. They know what's up. But they're leading you straight to the slaughter. Just like the Jews back in Jesus' day that hated him. They didn't want El to show up. They didn't want Emmanuel. They wanted their own system to do what they want. So now when they wash out all the Christians, they can have their whole world without any of us in it. No sheep allowed. No sheep in the system. Get them out of here. So there it is again. Now, here's a great representation of a guy, and I'm just going to show you. I put angel wings on this guy. He's having sex, and the scorpion stinging him right in the back. There it is. I'll enlarge that once, and there, boom, there's the sting. Oh, death, where's thy sting? What do you think the sting of death was? Yeah, there you go. So this guy's having sex with a scorpion. Who in the world would come up with that image? What a weird image. You know what? It's true. We've been having sex with an underground race, and their above ground race is the ones we're having sex with, and we're creating this whole system. When you die, they get your soul. That's what this is all about. Now you know what the whole world's about. That's what's going on. And, you know, it's like, try and argue with all the proof. It's not arguable. Okay, so they're ready. The little girl said, we're ready. Then we're ready. We come out of the darkness and strike like a scorpion. Here's a commercial where they're all singing, we ready, we ready, we ready for y'all. And let's see, where's the coach doing the scorpion strike? And so the coach does his little scorpion strike right here. There you go. We ready. Who's ready? The scorpions from the pit are ready to come out and strike. There you go. Next commercial. What about Us? The movie Us. Okay, so it's about a family. They're going on vacation, and everyone ends up having their own evil doppelganger. Well, that's convenient. That's exactly what I've been telling you. There's a good you, and there's a bad you. There's a double you. What's the number I keep telling you guys is the number they love? Roman numeral 5, Roman numeral 5. Put them together and it makes a W. 5 and 5, W. X in the middle, X chromosome. This is their lingo. I speak their language now. I've discerned it. Ready? Listen to the song.
That's a classic right there.
I got 5 on. Look at the little kid. He's wearing a little mask on the top of his head. It's a vampire. Okay, here we go. Ready? Watch this. Oh, I'm going to pause it right there. Let me show you something. I know Who holds people like that? You see her with her arm around the little girl? It's a V. Arm around the little kid? It's a V. What's a kid got on his head? A vampire. Uh-huh. What's on his chest? A V. I told you. This is the same thing over and over. Now watch.
What are you people?
It's us.
It's us. It's us. Because that is what the entire human race is. There's good and bad, and those demons are going to come up out of that pit, just like the Scion commercial. Wait a minute. Let's see. I think we have the Scion commercial right here. Oh my gosh. Wait a minute.
In a world that is bland, colorless, and cold, where banality grows like a fungus or a mold, there live the boring sheeple.
So, let's see. Now, again, this is a car commercial? What the hell? like, how many miles per gallon does it get? You know, what kind of interior does it have? What kind of tires does it come with? You know, some of the questions that might be good to have answered when you buy a car. You know, if you're into your speed, 0 to 60 might be good to know. Stuff like that. You know, but we're talking about a Scion. Oh, because Scion is like the thing Mount Scion in the Bible, right? Here we go. Let's see. The boring sheeple. Is this selling you a car, or is this mocking another race that you're destroying?
Who look just like each other. A darker force rides into town, unleashing demon brothers. Here come the little deviants. They come from underground.
Here come the little deviants. They come from underground. Oh, this has got to be a car commercial, obviously, because I saw a red car. There's no doubt about it. It's a car commercial.
They're rising from the depths to take those sheeple down.
This is really important. So this demon jumps out. They're rising from the depths to take those sheeple down. So this one jumps out and he's able to put on some sheepskin. And and then he's going to lead the other sheep astray. Like, we have people in our lives that lead us into all kinds of sin, and we get involved in all kinds of things we shouldn't do.
Sheeple are compliant and make for fine ingredients. For customizing anything, here come the little deviants.
So the sheeple are compliant and make for fine ingredients. You know what an ingredient is? I mean, you know, typically if you're watching Chopped. Oh, by the way, I ever watched the, you know, the cooking show Chopped? Isn't it interesting? There's a meat cleaver that goes between the letter P and the letter P and splits them in half. Oh, like double P's cut. See what I'm talking about? It's in everything. The sheeple are compliant because you don't resist them. I do. And make for fine ingredients. Oh, that be it's because you're food. For customizing anything. Here come the little deviants. Well, y'all know what an emoticon is, or is an emoji. You know, we got them on our phones now. Well, if you have an X and a D, that means it represents your eyes squinting really tight and your mouth open really wide, smiling, making a D because you're laughing really hard. Because they're laughing their ass off at you while they kill you. That's why. That's what's up. Look, watch. What kills him? Let's see. There's that old Scion we're trying to buy. Oh, see, here we go. Another reflection. Didn't we see a reflection in the Maserati commercial? The little girl looking at a reflection? Wasn't there a reflection in the Adidas original commercial? The guy in front of the mirror? The dancer dude? You know, all the reflections of himself? Yeah. Huh. Wasn't there two girls back-to-back that had their own doppelgangers, you know, in the Adidas commercial? I thought there was. Huh. What about the movie Us? Oh, that's right. They all had their own evil doppelganger, and the boy had a vampire mask on. Starting to wake up. We're in the world, but we're not of the world. We're from the kingdom of heaven now. Jesus has called us out of the world because we got our duality fixed. That's why he was crucified between two guys. I'm going to show you the scripture right now so you know. It shows right here in Ephesians 2. I'm going to read it to you so you see it with your own eyes. I am trying my best to give you all the knowledge I have. And I have so much knowledge, I literally can't contain it. It is overwhelming. Okay, Ephesians 2. Here you go. Ready? And I don't like the NIV. For some stuff, it's okay. For people that are not approved in the Word, it's easy to show them some stuff. But, okay. Here we go. That at that time, you were without Christ, being aliens from the commonwealth of Israel and strangers from the covenants of promise, having no hope and without God in the world. But now, in Christ Jesus, you who are sometimes far off are made nigh by the blood of Christ. For he is our peace. See, because he wants you to be at peace. Did you know that's what the new Jerusalem is? Jerusalem means city of peace. So everyone that gets converted, we become at peace with ourselves and we become a temple for God to occupy. I'm at peace. I'm no longer at odds with myself. I did a bunch of bad stuff in my life, and Lord forgave me. So now I'm at peace. I'm good with it. Thank you. That's what he came for. Look, for he is our peace, who have made both one. Oh, you mean like the Adidas commercial where the two girls are sitting back to back? Oh, like the Maserati commercial where the little girl is looking into her own reflection. Oh, like the Scion commercial where the sheep's head gets ripped off by his own reflection because behind his reflection is a demon that tears his head off. You see? It's all biblical, every bit of it. Both. So he is our peace, who hath made both one, and has broken down the middle wall of partition between us, having abolished in his flesh the enmity. You know where that enmity started? That enmity started in Genesis 3, right here. I'll show it to you. Because of what happened, it says, the Lord God said to the woman, what is this thou hast done? And the word for woman, by the way, is adulteress. See right there. And the God said to the woman, what is this thou hast done? And the woman adulteress said, the serpent, it means from its hiss, because it's not really a snake. It says to whisper a magic spell. Okay, so the serpent beguiled me, to lead astray, to seduce. You know what seduce means? I've been seduced before. I'm sure everybody has. The serpent beguiled me, and I did eat. And then look, I will put enmity, hostility, hatred, enmity, between thee and the woman, and between thy seed, between the seed of the serpent and the seed of the woman, I will put enmity between your two seeds. Look, and Jesus fixes that enmity, having abolished in his flesh the enmity, even the law of commandments contained in ordinances, for to make in himself of twain, which is two, one new man, so making peace. He's going to fix the situation and make one. Not a right side up, upside down one, which gets burned. Both right side up that come together as one, and you're free to go. Perfection in scripture again. Okay, so let's see. The sheep gets his reflection, rips his head off. Let's see, we'll get rid of that one. Okay, here's the Progressive commercial where all the sperm get out and go to different houses. A changing of the guard. Doot, doot, doot. There they all go. There's a changing of the guard. Oh, there you go. Protection by flow. Flotection. This is when the semen started flowing right here since 1937. Let's do it together. By the way, that's a scorpion stinger. And the reason she doesn't have eyes, she doesn't have an identity, is the exact same reason you saw a commercial where they played the song, you know, and she's not there, you know. There's something about her and the way she lied, you know, that one. The Coco Mademoiselle commercial that knocks the guy out and she's not there. Yeah, just like the girl and we're poison. Yeah, like that. Well, because their identity is hidden. It's Genesis 1:26, a phantom, an illusion. That's why Flo has no eyes right here, and that's why that's a scorpion stinger with what coming out of it? Poison. Look, Flotection since 1937. So all I have to do to understand that is type in Strong's 1937. And what did a bunch of angels do? They desired and lusted after women. Oh, there you go. To desire, lust after, I long for, covet, lust after, set one's heart above. Upon. So where have I seen that before? Oh, in Genesis 3. And when the woman saw the tree was good for food and pleasant to the eyes and a tree to be desired, to delight in, but to covet, to lust after. Told ya. So that progressive commercial insurance is the Garden of Eden. Those are sperm getting out of a car, going to the yards, changing of the, you know, what lives in the yards. That's why the Obama presidential poster, he's got a big sperm on the side of his head that makes a serpent fang. And there's another sperm being eaten by a serpent on the face of Obama in his presidential portrait. Who could even think, that's just like, who could even think this stuff up? Nobody. Look at how much data you're getting right now. Oh, my Lord. One of these things would be supernatural. But what, 20 in a row? Protection by flow? Flotection since 1937. Since angels started longing and coveting and lusting after and setting their parts upon a scorpion race from the pit. Oh, I get it. Yeah, there you go. Oh, let's see. Here's a great scene right here where the girl goes up and changes. Oh, no, that's not a phallic thing. By the way, let me show you something. This is a face. This is an Egyptian eye, nose, mouth. That's an Egyptian wearing an Egyptian helmet right there. That's an Egyptian eye, nose, mouth, Egyptian helmet. Protection since Flotection since 1937, desire. And she just happens to be getting, that's ejaculation. That's what's going on here. No doubt about it. Let's do it again. Oh, avocados from Mexico. This ought to be good. Let's see. Ready? So they all walk in around a big penis of Osiris. That's the penis of Osiris. That's what it is.
Good afternoon and welcome.
What? I said good afternoon and welcome. Can we lose the masks? Just take them off. How can we be a secret?
How can we be a secret society? Look, he leans over and he hits stop. It's on track 23. There's two lines, you know, like time's up, two lines. 23 and 23 is 46. That's 23 chromosomes. And you know when he goes over there and does it? He does it at the 23-second mark of the commercial. Look right here. 23, 23. Pause. Oh, sorry.
How can we be a...
Sorry. Let's go back. He hits the pause button. 23, pause. Pauses it. 23 and 23, 46.
How can we be a secret society if we can't keep all of our secrets?
Do they know? They just showed you the greatest secret of all right in front of your face. Now, because they think they're part of a secret society and they're in the know, the real joke's on them. Because then they start eating avocados and they're like, what's going on? Like, they're making fun of them because they're self-cannibalizing. And the joke's really on them. So those that are in league with Satan and his minions, because there's a lot of people that are sold out that wanted to, you know, get stuff from this world. So they work with them. Just like the movie with Roddy Piper, the sunglasses. I forget the name of the movie. I'll think of it in a minute. Anyway, So they're making fun of them. Watch.
Can we fake the moon landing?
No, not yet.
Or that there are only 49 shades of gray?
They're suspicious, but that's not what I'm talking about.
What about Bigfoot?
Bigfoot's not real and everyone knows that.
Did they figure out we deflated the football?
No, we found a fall guy for that one.
Bigfoot's definitely real.
Nope. Okay. We'll just have to agree to disagree.
What about Area 51? Do they know about that?
No.
How about Area 52 to 54?
No, stop saying areas. No areas plus a number.
Literally hundreds of photos of Bigfoot.
Okay.
Yeah, I saw him once. Wait, see? Wait, Bigfoot? I'm getting it wrong. Paul Bunyan?
Point is, someone is leaking this stuff.
Why are you looking at me?
I'm not looking at you, Anne.
I've seen his footprint when I was
Scott! What they do know is that avocados from Mexico have good fats.
So they know they're healthy.
They know everything. Kyle, are you streaming this?
Is that not cool?
No, it's not cool. That's what secret means. It's a secret society.
Oh, wow. Secret, yep, yep.
Hey, I gotta like.
You gotta...
Did you see what he did? Secret, yep, yep. That's a scorpion thing.
Hey.
I want to see it again.
Oh, wow. Secret, yep.
Secret, see? Scorpion stinger. No one does that. When no one goes, oh, yeah, secret, secret, secret. He does a scorpion stinger. I told you, man, this is a bust. Watch.
Yep.
Hey, I got a like.
You got a like?
That was me.
I like you, too. At least they don't know about subliminal advertising.
That's not even a thing, right?
Eat them!
Subliminal advertising. Eat them, and look, all of a sudden they're chowing down. Did you know that avocados take exactly 9 months to grow from flower to fruit, just like a child in the womb? It's shaped like the uterus. Did you know that? They're mocking the crap out of us. Look at this. This is sick.
What the?
What the? Like, what's going on? They're making fun of them like they don't even know. Ready? So, here you go. See, there's track 23 right there, track 23, two lines. That's no different than the Twin Towers. Look, I'll take two DNA strips and put them right there, 23. I'll take the Twin Towers and just slide them right up there, 23. Okay, I'll take the Arch of Washington. I'll put the Twin Towers right under there. It's exactly what's on the $20 bill. There's an avocado, look. There's an avocado. It's shaped identical to the uterus. It takes exactly 9 months for a baby to fully develop in the womb. It takes an avocado exactly 9 months to grow from a blossom to ripen fruit. Look at the, by the way, that's a random image, Octavia Butler, who wrote Bloodchild about a race of insects that hold humans captive while taking care of them while using them to breed their own race. Everything I've just shown you is perfection. How does somebody do that? It's because it's not me doing it. That's the only explanation. It's the Holy Spirit using me to show it to you. That's why, you know, there's a lot of people that have really dug their own ditches. I feel sorry for them. Okay, so there's that. Now, there's that. Now, let me show you how obvious it is about getting saved. Ready? Anybody see the movie National Treasure? Has anybody seen the movie National Treasure? I'm going to put it up on the screen. What's the movie about? This guy, he's looking for this giant Illuminati treasure, right? National treasure. Some big Illuminati treasure. Okay, but when in their course to go find the treasure, they get stuck way down sub-level below the ground in this like a shaft that had an elevator. And the bad guy took the elevator out. There's no way out. They're going to die down there. So they're going to die down in the pit. Exactly. So they're down in this pit. And there's no way out, but Nicolas Cage happens to have this pipe. And this pipe is in the shape of a castle with its subjects like a kingdom. And he's got it in his pocket. He's been carrying it around the whole movie. Have y'all ever heard of a pipe that has a name? Listen, my dad used to smoke pipes. I used to buy my dad pipes as gifts for birthdays. I used to buy him some pipes that are called meerschaum pipes. Sometimes when I really wanted to give my dad a really great gift, I would splurge, spend a couple $100 and buy him a meerschaum pipe. And the reason meerschaum are so great, they're made of seafoam. And they're hardened seafoam. And the product itself, the material itself, is really porous and lets air go through. So for a pipe smoker, it's like, you know, the coup de grace pipes. My dad used to like, oh, meerschaum pipe, yay. So anyway, in the movie National Treasure, Nicolas Cage has been carrying around this meerschaum pipe in his pocket. Isn't it weird I'd know what a meerschaum pipe is? Yeah, he carries it around. Oh, seafoam. That's not euphemistic for sperm, is it? Oh, yeah, it is. Look it up. Look up the name Seafoam aka sperm. Oh, you know, like Ariana Grande in her movie, in her video, God is a Woman, when she's in that little canal, you know, frothing around with all the guys. Hang on, let's just do them. We'll come right back to National Treasure. Let me go right here to let me go right here to Ariana Grande. Ariana Grande. Sorry. God is a woman. Here we go. God is a woman. And watch this. Here we go.
You.
And here we go. There she is. See, there's Ariana Grande with a bunch of dudes frothing around. There you go. Oh, that's not the like the uterus, or that's not the vaginal canal or anything, is it? She's upside down and there's a bunch of guys all covered in sperm. I mean, sea foam, I mean, shaving cream, I mean, white stuff. No, probably not. No, I don't know what I'm talking about. Let's go back. Okay, so here is back to this. He's going to take a sea foam pipe and put it in here, and then he says the strangest thing. He says, could it really be that simple? Well, did you know what? Getting saved is that simple. You just turn everything upside down. That's the thing the Lord God did to me the night I got saved. The very first words, the very first sound in my spirit I ever heard the Lord's voice was, Jonathan, read the tags in the clothes you're carrying. See how that shirt has a tag in it? And I was carrying a couple of shirts and a pair of pants, and I was like, I looked at my girlfriend Eleuthera and I said, that is the strangest thing. Some source is communicating with me, telling me to read the tags in these shirts I'm carrying. I threw the shirts down on the bed, and the first tag I read said 100% nylon. That's a great message from the Lord, right? No. And I read it, and I said 100% nylon. I said, that doesn't make any sense. And then I heard, turn it upside down. So I turned it upside down. It said 100% over here. No lion, Noyn, no line. Like 100% no line is the same thing as 100% truth. Wow. And so I turned it upside down and read 100% no line. And I said it out loud to the roof of a hotel room. And I went, 100% no line? My whole body started just buzzing like someone was shocking me, but in a good way. And I was just like, what in the world is this? These are old Vlad eyewears, vampire sunglasses. Some of my older models. And I was like, oh my gosh, what is going on? What is this? 100% no line. You wanted to know the truth. Well, if you want to know the truth, just turn everything upside down. Why do you think I turned the Virgin upside down and it's a dead sheep? Because the Virgin, you know, from Genesis 1, all the females that were created by that other race of upside down originals. Yeah. Angels that wanted that got in trouble. Now, look at what little now ready? Listen. Let me turn the volume all the way up. Could it really be that simple? So look at the pipe. It was up, he's looking at it, it's upside down. Then watch what he does with it. It represents a kingdom. Watch. Wait a minute. The secret lies with Charlotte. See, that's one of the clues he found out during his little hunt for the greatest treasure there was. The greatest treasure there is your own soul. There is no greater treasure than your own soul being bought back for you. That's the greatest treasure. So he says, could it really be that simple? The secret lies with Charlotte. Let's look up Charlotte before we go any further. Let's do it. I love doing this, man. This is so easy. Ready? Meaning of name Charlotte. So I'll go here. I'll open a new window. I'll type in meaning. meaning of, let's see, there, look, meaning of Charlotte right there, because I've looked it up before. Meaning of Charlotte right here. Ready? Charlotte is a girl's name because you're in a female system, meaning free man. Oh my gosh. Wait a minute. The secret lies with Charlotte, but Charlotte means free man? Well, watch what he does with Charlotte. He puts Charlotte into this hole. He takes the stem like a phallic symbol and sticks it in and turns it upside down. And then he gets the greatest treasure there is. And guess what? There's also a way out to go up. Oh. Can you say Johnny's got the code cracked? Say it. Say it. See the kingdom? Look, it's a castle. It's a kingdom. All the people of the kingdom, right? It's made out of sea foam. Seafoam is euphemistic for semen. Put it in. Turn it upside down. And Charlotte made you a free man. Oh my God.
Okay, this is the movie now.
So then the door opens up. And when the door opens up.
Of the phallic symbol. And the greatest treasure there is, and the door opens, and they found the treasure.
Oh, they're not holding torches that are two different DNAs, right? One with a man, one with a woman. You get it? Isn't this cool? Isn't it cool to know all this? It's like, we know everything. So cool. We know everything now.
Could it really be that simple?
DNA wrapped around.
All you had to do was put the stem in and turn it upside down. And the meaning of the name Charlotte means a free man. So could it really be that simple? All you have to do is turn it upside down and you become a free man. The secret lies with Charlotte. There it is. And you get the greatest treasure there is. Okay, so now they found...
Okay, so there it is. So, you see what I mean? Uh-huh. I mean, you know, this is probably nothing to worry about. Of course guys should be crawling around in a bunch of sea foam with Ariana doing triangles with her legs with her head upside down. Of course. That's normal. Totally. I told you so. Okay, now I'm going to get real serious. So, what do you think? Pretty cool, huh? All right. That's it. Busted. Look at what you saw. Look at what you got to see. You got to see past the veil today. Okay, so now we have a whole bunch of data to go over. I'm not going to do it on this video. We have folder after folder after folder after folder after folder. I'm going to go through pictures one at a time, and I'm going to show you their system. W, look. Look at Miley Cyrus. Look. Look. Winking her eye. Look. There's a good you, and there's a bad you. And she's winking her eye and sticking out her tongue. There's a double you because Miley's one of them. God bless her. Hunted for Jenna, hunting angels. What's hunting angels? Scorpions. Look at that girl. I like where the little claws are. Nice. Nah, it's probably nothing to worry about. Tool. Oh, is that a penis and testicles? That's the tool. One right side up, one upside down. There's the singer for Tool. What? You got a scorpion tail coming up your back? Random. Okay, so we're going to do this for the next video. I'm going to call this video, you know, just I think you guys have gotten the point today. Anyway, yeah, we got them. The end of the world's here. Now, I want to tell everybody something. You need to warm yourself up to this. If you're not ready to die, you're not ready. There's no getting, you know, if people are thinking, oh, whoa, you know, things are going to get better. No, this is the end of the world. I'm an end of the world harbinger. Like, ding, ding, ding. The, you know, like Noah said, there's a big flood coming. I'm the fire guy. That's why my ministry was called Before the Fire. I'm going to ring the bell before the fire, because the fire's coming, and he's going to destroy root and branch. The whole thing gets burned. So if you're not ready to die, you're not ready yet. You need to make your peace with the Lord God, because now you know the truth, and the truth should set you free, and you shouldn't be afraid of death now, because death is only the beginning. I love you guys. Group hug. I love you guys. Yes, we're going to go home. We get to go home. If you've been converted, you get to go home. If you haven't been converted, you're going to stay here and get refined and hopefully get converted. But it's going to be, yep, a lot of people are going to die that way. They're going to cut off the heads of a lot of people. That's what's coming. All right, I hope you guys enjoyed the presentation. There's the truth. This is hunting this, and the shadow of this is that. And here you go. 100% nylon. The night Johnny got saved, the Lord said, turn it upside down. And I read it 100%, no lion. And that's why the guy named YG, which means brother of understanding, if you speak their language, Y is the 25th letter of the alphabet, G is the 7th. And the number for 257 right here is brother of understanding, intelligent one. Selek. Told ya. Brother of understanding. That's why the rapper's name, he named himself YG. His real name's like Kevon, Davon, something, something. But his name's not YG. He picked the letter Y because it's 25. He picked the letter G because it's the number 7. He tells everybody it means young gangsta. No, it's YG because it's 257. Brother of understanding, because he knows we're all being hunted for dinner. That's why his clothing line's called 400, which means hunted for dinner. And what are they hunting? Well, that's made obvious by what's on his clothing. He's got an angel. There you go. See, they're hunting angels. Hunting angels, hunted for dinner. Angels being hunted for dinner. And that's why his clothing line, and I'll end it on this, he's got a set of shoes that are called bait, because if you got a host body, you owe Satan your soul now. You got your host body, pay up. So unless you get converted, you got your host body, now he gets your soul. That's why that Heineken commercial is one of the most perfect commercials ever. So look at YG's clothing. Look at this. Watch this. YG bait. YG Reebok classic. Nylon. Why do we care if it's nylon? Look at this. The bait. See, 400. You know what 400 is in Strong's? Watch this. Let's do Strong's 400. This is amazing. Watch. Strong's 400, then I'll wrap it up. I mean, no, I'm just on a little bit of a roll, right? Watch this. 400. See, I can do this all day long. Strong's 400 means food, prey. See, we're hunted for dinner. Look. See, look. Food supply, mealtime, prey. We're hunted for dinner, just like it says. So let's see. Where is my picture? Bait. Okay, so look. Lost Angels, so let's break it down. What's on this shoe? It says Lost Angels, which is right. 400, right, we're prey. Look what's in the middle. A V, that's the number 2 and the number 0. That's also a fish hook. And it's you know, skeleton, because you're dead. It represents death. But look at this. The bait, Reebok Classic, nylon, 400. Hunted for dinner, no lion. Oh, look at this. Hunted for dinner, no lion. Hunted for dinner, no lion. Bait. YG, brother of understanding. Bait. Hunted for dinner, no lion. Oh my God, he knows what I know. But he doesn't know who I know. And here's another pair of his tennis shoes. Right there. White with black laces, black with white laces. Are y'all starting to get this? Do you know where you're at now? You're in their world. We were carried away captive from heaven because of what we did. We got exiled. The Bible says, live out your life as exiles. Woohoo! Yes! All glory to God! I love you guys. We're going home soon. Praise God. I think I'm going to go outside and do a little gardening. It's so crazy. It's like, yeah, you got to have a sense of humor about this kind of stuff. It's so crazy. All right, guys. I love you. God bless.